Kirby Gottman and Brett Ely, they are always with us all the time in our board meetings, trying to keep us organized, keep us focused, and keep us in the right direction. So thank you very much for all that you guys do. I do this also, I really thank Dr. Harvey for his continued support throughout the years. I think we all know how important it is to have a president who sees the value of that and continues to support us in an adequate way without breaking the point very much of the goal as well. The goal was founded in 1969. I don't think that's even a secret anymore. We started with four individuals. We have grown tremendously since then. Our goal is to raise money to help support the department and then at the same time support the student athlete experience. And we all value those things. For those of you who are in the Gold Pro Club, I do thank you very much for your participation in the club. You'll be seeing our faces again, maybe hearing our voices over the phone. Here shortly as our drive begins for the coming season. But for those of you who may not be, we'd love to have you join us because we know the importance of giving back and also helping support those student athletes along the way. Our board is all a volunteer board, and our mission still remains the same. At this time, I'd like to have our Gold Pro Club members please stand for the words and recognize. Please stand. To our student athletes, we all say thank you for your dedication to the university, to your sport, to your coaches, and to the Griffin family. Seniors, I'd like to speak to you just briefly for just a moment. I want to thank you, first of all, for making us proud to be Griffins. Your excellence on the field and the arenas make us proud every day. And I've often said that when you lose, and when you win, we win. And I thank you so much for all you've done to make those things successful. I want to ask, first of all, that you look around for just a moment, seniors especially, at those people who are at your table, or perhaps maybe sitting beside you. I think those people in those spaces are important because they've been a part of your life, your success, what you do, not just as a person, but what you give here and give back. They will go with you wherever you go. We've all had great friendships that have started at this university, and some are best friendships. Even 45 years later are those we acquired here. So look around and make sure you appreciate those faces and those people who have been with you. The biggest thing I try to tell the seniors and certainly everybody else is this is your home. This is the one that you built. We want you to come back. You have been always a part of this program, but you are forever a Griffin. It has been our tradition on the Gold Pro Club for the past probably 8 or 9 years to give a year's membership, the basic one, to all the seniors who have graduated or leaving our program. It is our way of saying thank you for all you have given, but we want you back. And you've heard me say this time and time again. You can leave, but don't go away. We want you back to be a part of this program because you are, in fact, our future. And finally, for some of you who have a brief moment, you may have heard it say again, but others will. Some people come into our life and they leave, and others come and stay for a long time. They come because they make a difference in our life. It makes our life more meaning. They brighten our lives and our purpose. This evening we honor someone who has stayed and who's made a difference. He stayed the course. He's helped others. He remains very dedicated to his family, to his friendships, and to this Griffin family. The Valor Award was established in 2011. It has been awarded to 3 recipients. It is my absolute pleasure this evening to honor the 4th. He is a former student athlete, a Hall of Fame member, in football not only as a team member, but as an individual. He chairs the Missouri Western Hall of Fame, always works on the smallest details because he wants it to be right. In addition to those, he is a member of the Gold Card Gold Pro Board. I believe if you were to look up the meaning of valor in the dictionary, it would say Scott Brown. Over 3 years ago, Scott was diagnosed with prostate cancer. During that time, he retired from his work for 23 years at Bristol Myers as district manager, where he has awarded the company's Pinnacle Award 6 times. He is accompanied this evening with his lovely wife, Edie, who has also retired, so they can fight the fight together. Even though this battle continues, Scott continues to give back to the university his time, his leadership, and his loyalty, and always with a kind word and a gentle smile. Senior athletes, just as I ask you to remember those faces who surround you today and make a difference in your life, we too share the opportunity to recognize someone who made a difference in ours. The awards and the awards we presented to the student athlete, coach, or contributor to Griffin Athletics who have strengthened a mind and spirit to enable a person to endure life's challenges and resolve and courage. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my extreme honor to present the 2015 Valor Award to a dear friend who I love with the greatest respect, Mr. Scott Brown.
Courage, and those prayers have been answered abundantly. In prayer, I thank God for those answered prayers. Second is family. Family is really difficult because it cuts both ways. On the negative side, there is tremendous guilt for the hardship this disease places on their shoulders. I've heard it said, when someone has cancer, the whole family and everyone who loves them does too. Thankfully, the positive far outweighs the negative. And my very best example is the unwavering love and support my wife of 28 years, Edie, has given from day one. Third are friends, many of whom are in the room tonight. Friends may not even know the important role they have in helping someone battle cancer. Every card, text message, caring bridge post, phone call, warm handshake, or hug really does make a difference. Friends and faith blend a little bit here. The Lord truly does work in mysterious ways. So often, the kind gesture of a friend seems to come at a time when it's most needed. One quick example. One quick example is a phone call I received just days after my first surgery. I was still in great pain, still had a urinary catheter, and feeling pretty disappointed about what lay ahead. This friend is someone most of you know, and unknown to me, had been through his own prostate surgery years earlier. He was calling to let me know about that diagnosis. His surgery, that he's cancer-free now, and that there really can be light at the end of the tunnel. That call came at a time I needed it most and changed everything about my outlook that day. The next F is foundation. It's really hard to say that any one of these F's is more important than another. But the reality is just like building a house, building a life is all about a strong foundation. My foundation in this context is Missouri Western. Like so many of you here tonight, as Zach mentioned, I was a student athlete at Missouri Western. The 18-year-old me, well, I had no clue my years here in the classroom and on the football field were preparing me for all the challenges life presents. Sure, I was having fun playing football, and I certainly hoped my degree would get me a job at graduation. Fast forward 40 years, though, and the 58-year-old me has an entirely different perspective. I may not even be in the fight today without my student-athlete experience. The student part of student-athlete prepared me well. Because of the great academic foundation from Western, I was able to go on and earn an MD, an MBA, and then build a 25-year career at Bristol-Myers Squibb, the worldwide diversified healthcare company. Because of my long experience in healthcare, I've been able to truly understand my condition, and more importantly, navigate the healthcare system to make good treatment decisions. All of this made possible because I was a student-athlete at Missouri Western. The athlete part, student-athlete, was spent playing football. Again, I could not have asked for a better life preparation from seeing the importance of envisioning big goals to relying on teammates, from making incremental improvement to overcoming adversity, and so much more. Every part of my Western athletic experience prepared me not just for the battle, but for living my life, the entire life. When I was 18, life was good. I was indestructible. In fact, if I were in the audience of the student-athlete honors banquet back then, I'd be wondering, how does any of this apply to me? By the way, we didn't have a student-athlete honors back then, and it's probably a good thing, because I was neither the student nor the athlete that our honorees are this evening. I've attended most of these student-athlete banquet honors over the years, and I'd like to take this opportunity to thank the St. Joseph News Press for their support of this truly outstanding event. I always come away feeling what a great job our coaches do bringing the best people to our university, and I am uplifted by your personal stories. For all the student athletes in the audience this evening, if you've ever wondered whether the early morning workouts are really worth it, or as I did many times, what does this professor have to do with any class, have to do with anything in my future? Just ask Jessica Cook, the 2012 female honoree who holds the women's basketball career scoring record, or Travis Partridge, last year's male honoree who quarterbacked the football team to an MIAA championship, for their peer perspective. Or maybe, think about me and how my student athlete experience at Western prepared me for challenges 40 years later that no 18-year-old could have possibly anticipated. That's why the foundation you're building at Missouri Western is so important to you. My last F is future. I maintain a focus of great hope for my future. Four wonderful physicians and their teams that have provided me the best care anyone could ask for give me that optimism. They're Dr. Andriel at Barnes Hospital in St. Louis, Dr. Massey at University of Kansas Cancer Center, Dr. Kwan at the Mayo Clinic in Rochester, Minnesota, and Dr. Crane at the University of Kansas Cancer Center. Excuse me. All have been spot on in their treatment, and more importantly, to me, understanding and caring clinicians. They have my enduring thanks for giving me hope for my future. And so, on behalf of my faith that sustains me, on behalf of my family that supports me, on behalf of my friends who strengthen me, on behalf of the solid foundation that prepared me, and on behalf of the future that gives me hope, I thank you for the opportunity to speak from my heart this evening, and I humbly accept the award.